Hi there, Tom here. I want to talk to you a little bit about some of the findings from our third annual observability survey. We had over 1,200 responses, but I just want to focus in on, this executive involvement finding from the survey. So let's have a look. So one of the questions we ask is at what layer in your organization is your observability strategy being led, right? And the most common answer now is CTO level. And that kind of surprised us, right? That's a big uptick, a big acceleration from last year. We're also seeing organizations and people that answered questions with C-suite engagement had much stronger adoption of pretty more, more advanced techniques, right? So these things like SLOs, things like profiling, distributed tracing, things like unifying your application and infrastructure observability. We find this interesting because we're also seeing the same pattern, at Grafana Labs with the adoption of our technology. And previously Grafana, very much something for the early adopters and innovators, for the tinkerers at the grassroots of the organization, those that want to, put together their own observability system and build their own dashboards and learn these fantastic query languages. Now we're starting to see Grafana be something that CTOs are interested in, that they have executive level dashboards reporting on business KPIs. And we see the same trend in adoption of our technology, but it's great to see that this is a wider industry trend. Let's dig into a little bit more of the data. The other thing we're starting to see is a much broader adoption of SaaS. So there's been an uptick in companies responding that they're taking a SaaS-only approach to observability. That was good to see, considering we also sell SaaS software. But I can understand why people are doing that. These modern observability platforms are getting increasingly complex, increasingly hard to operate. And, businesses are looking to focus on their core capabilities. So they don't want to do the kind of undifferentiated heavy lifting of running observability platforms. So it makes sense that you were seeing more adoption of SaaS. So another one that stands out is how central observability teams are becoming both more prevalent and more mature, right? We see this as a trend kind of correlating with the adoption of SaaS, because these teams are now moving on from focusing on just operating a big time series database or a log aggregation system, and more, providing best practices, evangelizing for how to get the most value out of said systems, right? And this counts because they're not operating them anymore. The free cycles they have from freeing up, the operations over to a SaaS vendor allows them to focus on getting the most value out of that technology and driving its adoption through a wider organization. So lastly, I just want to talk about distributed tracing, right? So we saw companies with that exec level buy-in for their observability strategy were much more likely to have a consistent distributed tracing story, right? We also saw tracing squarely now as the third most popular signal and quickly catching up to metrics and logs. But lastly, I was also quite surprised to see, it's companies with those central observability teams that are really leaning into tracing, somewhere where you can lead for best practices, somewhere where you can identify the dead spots for tracing and maybe come in and repair some of that. And this makes a lot of sense. I'll also say we are seeing an industry trend of a shift for instrumentation more towards a platform responsibility, with the rise of technologies like eBPF and Beyla, really driving the ability for your platform to automatically instrument your code without the developers involved. So it makes sense that would come from a central observability team, and that they could lead that effort. And that's one of the key things that unlocks a lot of the value in distributed tracing. So yeah, that's some of my thoughts from the observability survey. If you disagree with any of my kind of analysis here, or honestly, if you have alternative explanations for some of these trends we're seeing, please do leave a comment below. Like and subscribe, I think, is the right way to say this. This is my first YouTube video, I think. But yeah, and if you want to know more about the data, go to grafana.com. We've got this really cool interactive dashboard that you can kind of drill into the data on play.grafana.com. And thank you for listening. Okay, so let's dig into a few more of the data. I mean, technically that is correct, because my wife always likes to tell me that data is a plural, or data are a plural rather. But I just think Americans will be freaked out by the English guy if he says that.